The Dow has suffered the longest weekly losing streak of the year. However, the Nasdaq soared as Berkshire has been buying Amazon. And what about the jobs report? Lastly, the VIX has now risen for 3 straight weeks, the longest streak for the VIX since October 2018. So, let's take a look at the charts. Stay with me as we're going to take a look at a few charts today, beginning with the spiders. The SPY, the close on Friday, 294.03. Not much has happened since we talked last time. The bottom there, the top here. Well, what did happen is we're at record territories, previous high at that point there, and then before that was in early 2018. By the price chart, everything looks good, but I would say that risks still haven't been wrung out yet. Let's look at the back. This looks great with the bottom there. The acceleration on up, both in the fast line and the slow line above zero, well above zero, and that looks real good. A little bit of hesitation here in the histogram. Looks like things may start to turn over here, but it's only a slight turnover, and it's going to be a while before that really causes any trouble. Steep decline on the price rate of change. We expected that because it came up here so far and has to come down quite a ways. But I expect this to head back up here in the near future. Relative strength still is providing a bit of a problem. 74.01 at that level here, which is still below here and still below this as well. So again, we still have that slight downward trend, that divergence. Also, stochastics, the fast line is approaching the slow line, not quite ready to move through, but it may, but it also may reflect back up. No big concern yet either for that. Minor concern is the overall trend, downward trend in the volume. And here we have the Williams. The Williams looks just fine. Let's go back up here to the price chart. Now take a quick look at that. We're now going to go to the Dow. So do a comparison. And we're now looking at the 2-year weekly chart on the Dow, or the diamonds. And looking at this here, this doesn't look too bad either. Yet we're still at this level, not quite at a new high here. And the previous high there in early 2018 was there. Moving on down here to the MAC, we have the high at that point, early 2018. Here was the midterm sort of high in the September-October period of 2018, and here's where we are now. The MAC looks decent. It's above zero and seems to be accelerating with a decent separation, but it's still below this level here, and that's not a big concern. But I do think that there are some concerns coming here in the histogram. You can see that this is rolling over a little bit more than the S&P or the spiders. So that's a red flag there. Looking at the price rate of change, not unexpected. With that steep decline, moving here into the RSI, the RSI at 65.53 is weaker than the S&P. And you can definitely see that at this level here, previous high, and then up to that point there. This decline is a little bit steeper than the S&P. So again, that's something that we want to keep our eye on. I don't like that divergence. The stochastics, the fast line, is moving toward the slow line a little bit more steeply than the spiders. This fast line may move through. Doesn't mean everything is going to crumble, but that's something that you just want to watch because that's setting up some red flags. Volume as well. Slight decline. The Williams looks pretty good. I don't have any concerns with that. Back up here to the price chart. Again, somewhat of a head and shoulders here. Left shoulder, here's the head, and then the right shoulder. This right shoulder needs to move out of this up to the previous high and perhaps through it like the S&P. But now let's go to a bigger concern that I have. And this last chart here is the Russell 2000, the ETF. The symbol is IWM, current level 160.53. And this really sets up a better head and shoulders pattern than does the Dow. There's the right shoulder and then the head and then the left shoulder here. say back in early 2018. And that's the problem that I have with the overall markets, is you want the markets, all the indices moving in lockstep, but they're not. The Russell is well behind. It can catch up, but for now it's behind, and that's just a little bit of a concern. You can see here in the MAC came down to that level there, and we're now just getting above that zero level. There's good separation and good velocity here, but being that it's only popping its head above the zero, you can tell that things are a little weaker for the Russell. And the histogram is somewhat uncommitted here. It was rolling over, but then it just decided to go level. So not telling us much there. Price rate change, not much. Now into the RSI, again, same sort of red flag that we see in the other indices. The levels are declining, a slight decline, so that's a slight divergence, and you just don't want to see that. The other oscillators here look fine into the volume and the Williams. There are no complaints there. Back up to the price chart. I think my only complaint is simply that the head and shoulders pattern is showing up, and the current level is quite a bit below the previous high there. So all it means is things are running, they're running fine, they're running okay, but just keep your eye out for those red flags that are going to start popping up here. I'll have more for you on Monday, but for today, that's True Dog Charts. Thank you.